Good morning, boys and girls. We are going to read from the Jesus Storybook Bible. Our Bible lesson today is on the three wise men. My little helpers are going to help me tell the story, Sammy. Can you sit down? All right. The king of all kings.
We'll always do that one.
We're gonna do it again. Far away in the east, three clever men saw the very same star. The star that God had put in the sky when Jesus was born. They knew it was a sign. A baby king had been born. Have you guys seen the stars in the sky?
Yeah. I saw a big star.
A big star, no, yeah.
That big star and a big moon. I saw a big moon.
A big
moon. It was this tall.
Okay.
It was in our space.
All right, let's finish the story. They had been waiting for this star. They knew it would come. He's here, they shouted. He's here. And I'm sure if you'd been there, you would have heard them laughing and dancing and singing until the sun came up. At dawn, they packed up their camels and wrapped gifts for the baby. They brought their most precious treasures of all, frankincense, gold, and myrrh. Special, sparkly, lovely, smelling, gleaming things just right for a king. What would you wrap up for Jesus? Elijah.
I would wrap up for Jesus.
Yes.
A baby bottle.
A baby bottle? That's a good gift. What would you wrap up for Jesus?
A basketball.
A basketball?
And a basketball hoop.
And a basketball hoop?
And it's made of dirty stuff.
Okay. Sammy, you have any ideas?
Yeah. I just saw a poop star.
Oh, a star? Okay.
A poop.
All right, let's finish the story. The three wise men, actually, if you'd met them, you'd have thought they were kings because they were so rich and clever and important looking. Set off. They rode their camels across the endless desert, up steep, steep mountains, down into the deep, deep valleys, through raging rivers, over grassy plains.
In the trees.
In the trees, yep. Night and day, day and night, for hours that turned into days, that turned into weeks, and that turned into months and months. At last, they reached. Where do you think they reached?
Jerusalem.
Jerusalem. Okay, you guys.
That's a castle.
That's a castle. Can you sit down?
Those are castles too.
Okay. Can you sit down?
That's where baby Jesus was born.
Yeah. Well, don't tell them the story yet. We got to finish reading. Jerusalem was by far the most important city for miles around, and anyone can tell you that that's where a palace would be. Kings are born in palaces. So that's where they went. They were in for a surprise. They went to see King Herod. Surely he'd know where this baby was. But Herod didn't know where baby Jesus was. In fact, he didn't even like the sound of a new king. It made him cross. He didn't want anyone to be king except him. But Herod's advisors told the three wise men what was written in their books, what God had said about the baby king. Go to Bethlehem. That's where you'll find him. Suddenly, the star they had seen in the east started moving again, showing them the way. So the three wise men followed the star out of the big city, along the road into the little town of Bethlehem. They followed the star through the streets of Bethlehem, out of the nice part of town, through the not so nice part of town, into the not so really nice part of town, down a little dirt track until it stopped, right over a little house. But wait, it wasn't a palace. There weren't any guards or servants or flags or red carpets or trumpets or anything. Did they get it wrong? Or was this what God meant?
God meant.
That's what God meant. Sure enough, in that little house there sitting on his mother's knee, They found him, the baby king. The three men knelt before the little king. They took off their rich royal turbans and gleaming golden crowns, and they bowed their noble heads to the ground and gave him their sparkling treasures. The journey that had begun so many centuries before had led three wise men here, to a little town, to a little house, to a little child. To the king, God had promised David all those years before. But this child was a new kind of king. Though he was the prince of heaven, he had become poor. Though he was the mighty God, he had become a helpless baby. This king hadn't come to be the boss. He had come to be the servant.
He's a servant?
Mm-hmm.
When is he going to be a servant? He's a servant of God.
Mm-hmm. All right, Elijah, do you have the Bible verse for today?
Yes. God loves a cheerful giver.
Second
Corinthians 7.
9:7. Thank you. That was really good.
My turn.
You want to say it?
Uh-huh. How you do it?
God
loves
a cheerful giver.
Giver.
Second.
Corinthians 9:7.
Well, thank you, boys and girls, for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed the story.
And Bowser enjoyed it, too.